I'm sure you can help us a little bit, Nina, on the history of ventriloquism.
Well, I know that it has a very dark history and that ventriloquists used to earn their living as if their words were divine utterances.
Yes, that's the point.
Yes. Not you, dear.
Sorry, I was listening, but then my hand came out and it felt quite... shot myself.
That's really, that's really disturbing.
It's quite disturbing.
Really, really disturbing.
Lady Gaga's sleeves.
Well, yes, you're absolutely right. It was regarded as a divine utterance or demonic possession, in fact, wasn't it?
And I know one woman died from her ventriloquism.
Who was that?
But I don't know her name. I bet you do. With her utterances, she was objecting to the marriage of Henry VIII.
To Anne Boleyn.
To Anne Boleyn.
Her name was Elizabeth Barton. And she was known as the Holy Maid of Kent. And she was a very good ventriloquist. And so these voices would come without her mouth moving, as it were, from her stomach.
Nice to
in which
too.
She would... in which she would say things. And she became very, very popular until she started to say...
The bloke looking at her tits.
Yeah, well... we wouldn't do that.
You've got yours out as well tonight. Distract from the lip movement.
And she did very well. She was very popular until she said that if Henry VIII married Anne Boleyn, he would be deposed, and Henry VIII didn't like that at all, so had her head chopped off. And ironically, her head was put on top of a pole outside.
And carried on talking.
Well, you wonder about it. It is quite a strange fate for ventriloquists to have their head stuck on a pole. But she was indeed. She suffered for her art. But in the 19th century, it became known to be a piece of entertainment rather than demonic spirits.